Meanwhile, the investigation has revealed a sinister plan, a plan that will have implications not just for Sri Lanka, but the entire region, the whole of South Asia. At the center of this terror plot is a group we are all too familiar with in India, the Lashkar-E-Toiba. A report by the Indo-Asian News Service has revealed that the Lashkar had hatched a grand plot to attack Sri Lanka and its neighbors. The targets include India, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and the Maldives. The plan goes back to at least 14 years, 1-4. It's an awfully long time, you'd say. What has the Lashkar been doing all this while? They have been investing. They have been investing money and efforts consistently in Sri Lanka, in Bangladesh, in the Maldives, even in Malaysia. The idea is to surround India with hubs of terror. The report names a special group headed by a man called Muzammil Bhatt. Does that name ring a bell? This is the same Muzammil Bhatt of the Lashkar-e-Toiba, one of the planners of the 26/11 Mumbai terror attacks. Muzammil Bhatt also reportedly masterminded the 2002 Akshardham temple attack in India. The strategy was to set up a network across Lanka, Bangladesh and the Maldives. Bhatt's plan was to use these countries as launch pads. He wanted to train terrorists for a larger web of attacks, and within India, the Lashkar-e-Toiba believed that the center of terror was moving from Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra to the southern part of the country, but this was happening between 2005 and 2007. During those years, Indian intelligence and security forces kept a close vigil on South India. Bhatt decided that taking the training camps offshore would be a better idea, and that is why he chose Sri Lanka. He was testing the waters. He realized that there was traction amongst Tamil Muslims on this island. The community was devastated after the tsunami. Using faith as a healer, he decided that these vulnerable people can be radicalized. That is what the report says. The same was the case in Bangladesh. The focus was on Rohingya Muslims between 2004 and 2008. And all of this was watched very closely by the Indian intelligence. In 2011, a new name popped up on the radar. The name of Zakir Hussain. He began to actively recruit Tamil Muslims in Sri Lanka. The plan was to recruit Tamil Muslims and then attack diplomatic missions in Chennai and Bengaluru. It needs to be noted here that Zakir Hussain was assisted in his efforts by a man called Amir Zubair Siddiqui. Amir Zubair Siddiqui was then a consular in the Pakistan High Commission in Colombo. Siddiqui was also an officer of Pakistan's intelligence unit, the ISI, which should not come as a surprise because the Pakistani establishment's proximity to terror groups is no secret. The ISI is well known to have close links with the Lashkar-e-Toiba. So Indian intelligence officials, alert as ever, in Lanka and Bangladesh, were able to stop them successfully. Eventually, Zakir Hussain and another linchpin were caught in Malaysia and the cartel was busted. The report says that Sri Lanka has long been a breeding ground for radical Islam with Salafist tendencies. Terror groups like the National Tawheed Jamaat sprouted from them. And over the years, members belonging to these groups have managed to cross over to the southern Indian states of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. While India has boosted its security apparatus in these states, it needs to remain on a tight vigil, considering the threat at hand. The rise of the Islamic State and its aim at establishing a caliphate has certainly found takers in this region. In fact, New Delhi's intelligence inputs on Easter bombings came from interrogations of an ISIS suspect arrested in India.